Hey you guys, John Rocket TV One here, showing you my Harbor Freight 4939626 knee mill. And guys have been asking me, well, show me a review, show me something about the mill itself. Okay, so basically I've been a little bit slow coming out with these videos because I'm under-tooled for this machine. Meaning I don't have R8 collets, I have a lot of MT2 tools for my lids, including end mills, older stuff. And even milling vices, I'm short. So I've been picking up what I can, when I can, where I can. And so today I guess I will just show you a little bit about this machine. You can see I have an indicator on the spindle there. Okay, and I am indicating the inside of the taper, the R8. This is an R8 mill. And I have determined with my 1/2 thousand indicator that she is about 3/4 of a thousand, a run out. And that may be just a bumble on the inside. I haven't even gone in there to try and buff that out with a little bit of, you know, Scotch-Brite or something, just to take the curse off of it from the machine shop, whoever worked on it. But I think I got this mill home for around $1,400 in my driveway, delivered. All done with the 20% off coupon, and then I didn't have to pay for the liftgate because some of you guys saw me build my own little loading dock there, and then I built my own stand. Okay, so I didn't buy the Grizzly, but I will give you some of my observations here. So that is a 1/2 thousand dial, and I got a 1/10 dial, but for me right now, it's just not necessary. You could see the spindle's pretty good, okay? Pretty good. Yeah, it is a 2-horsepower motor. It's 220 volts, and I have since wired 220 into my garage here. The lead screws on the machine are supposedly 1-inch 8 TPI, and the dials are graduated to 125,000, and I have confirmed that I have approximately 3,000 of backlash in my screw, and that when I indicate with my Browning shaft here, I can come in at 125,000. So two rotates gives you 1/4 of an inch, 250,000. I know guys like to go 200 or whatever. You know, I can't speak to that, but there's the info for you. These are graduated in 125,000. Okay, I don't know. Hopefully you guys can see that there. A couple of things. They do use Bondo and this here red paint. And you can see when I bolted my machine down right here, you can see she got a little bit of a flake. As soon as I tightened the bolt there, this flake of Bondo came right off. And it looks like they did it right over a rusty casting. So, you know, you're not buying an American-made pot from 1960 or earlier. But it is, for me, a brand new machine. And, you know, I cannot beat the Chinese guys who put this thing together, because I don't see how I can get one into my house for any cheaper than that. I can't. Sometimes and rarely do a Bridgeport in good condition in this neck of the woods show up that you can actually get to your house for less than $2,000. Then you got to power it, then you got to tool it. So both, either way, at least I got myself a new machine, and I will work with its limitations just like everybody else. It's not rocket science, it's about patience. You know, a little bit of technical ability, which I will help you guys learn here and there as I can. And let's look at the machine a little bit more. Okay, so as you can see, I have a little, I did do a bit of a milling job on there. The machine comes with a JT33 R8 adapter for a drill chuck. And the only drill chuck that I had that actually fit that was the one from my little big dog lathe. And that thing is so, it's no good. I mean, they just run out so much, it's not even worth putting a drill bit in. I mean, by the time you get out 2 or 3 inches on the end of a drill bit, it might as well be looking like that, so forget about it. All right, I was able, they give you a face mill. I think it's 2.5 or 3 inches face mill with brazed on carbides. And I made this angle plate out of it after I trimmed the head. You guys can look at that video if you like. And there is only one way to trim the head on this. It's back and forth here across this way, but you cannot do nod with this machine like you could on a Bridgeport. One thing, when I'm not doing cutting NASA, camera lenses, I like to put a little oil sheet under my thing to keep it from rusting under your vise. Because out here, it's in my garage, it gets hot, cold, things rust, okay? Well, I wish I could say that every photo you're gonna see of my machine equipment, I put oil rags on everything out here because I have to keep stuff from rusting. You're not gonna see all these shiny, chromey pictures, guys looking up mini lids and stuff like that. You go to some of these web pages and they got this shiny machine. Well, you know what? You don't use it. And if I spent all day cleaning it, I'd never get nothing done. I do make sure it's oiled and I do make sure the chips don't get under the ways. Speaking of the ways, this dovetail on my Y here, you could see this is the bearing surface, not this, okay? This is the way cover, right? I mean the, the way wiper cover right here. And you could see that, I don't know, hopefully you're seeing that. It does look like they took a belt sander across the top of that, probably to take the burr off before they put the wiper on. I don't know. One little thought. However, on the bearing surface back here, behind the way cover, you can see that the castings that they actually send out the door are not perfect by any means, okay? You can see that spot, low spot right there with a bunch of Bondo filled in there. I could have probably called Harbor Freight and bitched. But for the money that I paid for this machine, it's got to live as long as me. And that's about it. And I'm certain that will do that. It is definitely missing a little piece there. And I was definitely discouraged when I saw it. And a little bit pissed off. But I could probably move 3 or 5 of these in and out of the building and find something like that on every one. So I just... I couldn't be bothered. For the money, I'm going to make the parts. I'm going to do it while I'm still alive. Is around the other side of the machine. I'm hoping you can see it. It is a 220 capacitor start motor. And it started up. It starts up beautiful. And it actually runs beautiful. It runs cool. Even when I was cutting that angle iron, I had no problem with it. The electrical box on the inside, I'm not going to take that cover off again, but it was fairly clean and fairly straightforward. If you have a little bit of electrical knowledge, wiring the 220 is just, again, it's fairly straightforward. If you don't know how to do it, have an electrician or somebody that knows how to do it do that for you. That way you don't get hurt and you don't burn up your machine. Okay, on the 626 forum over at Yahoo, I've been trying to get guys to help me out figuring out how do I get a power feed on here. And the Grizzly machine, the G3102, right, is the one that comes through with the power feed. Then you can get one that doesn't have it. And if you look closely at their table, I put rags with oil all over my stuff on there just because it needs it, in case I set my coffee down, guys are asking about the travel and how do I get a power feed onto this machine. Well, if you look at the graduated collets, I'll come over here on this side, hopefully the light will be a little better for you. These, if you look at the different brands, and I have hunted every machine that I could find with the different color paint jobs on it. And there is a guy who modified this to get about 4 more inches of travel in the X out of this, okay? And it has to do with this bearing cover, and I could stick my whole finger in there a good inch and a half before I get to the bearing. So what he did was cut this out of here. I probably won't do that. I will probably at some point pull those off, make them foamy out of it, and do a lost foam casting out of aluminum to get the extra travel out of my X. That being said, I have been trying to determine whether or not the Grizzly machine actually has a longer lead screw in the X direction, and nobody seems to want to hand me that information over there. So what I have come to, if you look at the Taiwanese made version of this machine, you will see that there is a big long naked section of lead screw hanging out of this side of the machine, the right hand side of the machine. And it looks to me on all of the other versions of this machine that this collar is not this wide. This is, you know, your graduated collar, and you could set this to wherever you want. You know, you get you set your pot, set your zero, slide this over, and then go. Okay. It looks to me like their collars are all shorter than this. I've been trying to determine whether or not I could go to Grizzly and buy the lead screw for the G3102 and stick that in this machine and then be able to mount a power feed, you know, a generic power feed onto this machine without having to cobble up all kinds of end caps and whatever. And so far I have not been able to determine that information, but it looks like I have this extra thick handle here and this extra wide graduated collar that may lend itself to just cobbling a power feed right on here without changing the lead screw. The lead screws are an inch eight, which I'm pretty certain that I have determined that that's exactly what is in this machine. 1 inch 8. Those threaded rod can be had from McMaster Car, and if you have a lathe, you can go ahead and turn those down yourself and make yourself the lead screw out of a threaded rod for about $60 or less. So that being said, is just another option if you want to put a power feed on here. There are guys that have done it. You know, you can make pulleys and hang some sort of barbecue motor off the back over here if you want. But I personally am not going to do that right off the bat. When I get to it, I get to it, and I will show you guys how I ended up doing it. Okay, about the Y travel. The Y travel also is another one of these things where I'm thinking, I don't remember the spec sheet exactly, but it's somewhere in the neighborhood of 6 inches or a little more. And if you look down in here, you'll see as the lead screw, it's actually dragging that cover width. The lead screw is right there, and there is about an inch and a half or 2 inches of travel right here that can be had by hogging this section out. Now, whether that is like that in all of these machines, I'm not quite certain. I can't say for sure. You will have to look at your machine. But on this here Hucky Freight 40939, it is definitely right there available to get yourself more wide travel towards the operator. So that is there. As far as the lead screw on the bottom, they're all supposedly the same thing. I have not taken this apart, the nut for the knee, whether or not, be sure you don't leave anything under here that isn't just flat, because you will come down and smash it. If you leave an indicator under there, or a spray paint can, or something dub like that, you will smash it. So as far as increasing the Z travel, in that direction, I can't speak to that. What I do when I'm using the machine is, the reason we bought the knee mill is so that we can have better accuracy and Z control without having to play with, you know, like the mill drills, the head, swing, and any slop in your spindles. I come up to where I need to be, and then I do definitely use the fine feed on my Z. You know, but I use it depending on how deep you have to go. I only use a half an inch of it or so, and that is to maintain the rigidity of the spindle itself. You know, you bring up, and then you go ahead and use your Z, the spindle feed, so that you can maintain the rigidity. You know, that's what the kneecap is about. These guys that they run 3 inches down with their spindle, that's like, you know, taking away from the machine. But of course, if you don't have a knee mill, well, then you got no choice. That's why we bought this one and not one of the G704s there. Speaking of the spindle and the Quill fine feed, mine was assembled wrong. So I had to take this clutch apart and put it back together. If you look at the drawing, I believe even the Grizzly drawing, they have it backwards where the spring and the clutch collar actually goes. And as soon as you figure that out, she works real nice, okay? Works real nice once you figure out that that's the problem with that, okay? Yeah. Turn that right in, tighten her up, and there she goes, okay? So until you figure out that yours is backwards, look at the drawing and then take that apart, okay? All right, you guys, so there is, all of this is cast iron pulleys, everything about it. I did anti-seize my, what do you call it, draw bar. And I anti-seize my collets before I stick them in there, in the thread. This should be dry when you put these in here, okay? And your collet should be dry. The key that's up in here is not for driving the tool. It is for locating the collet. That is it. And for helping that collet not spin when you unhook it with the draw bar. The one thing that I did find about this machine that kind of irked me again was when I had the big face mill in there, the spindle spline was rattling like a stuck pig. And that, according to my readings, is common with these machines, and even in my Hucky Freight drill press over there. The splines, they don't match them up at the factory when they assemble them, and they tend to rattle under load. So I probably could have called Harbor Freight and had them send me one, you know, 3 months down the road, or three or five different ones, and probably they would all suck. So I decided I'm not even gonna bother wasting my time. When I get around to it and I get set up, we will make us a new spline collar for this spindle, and we will put it in there, American made, and it will fit. And it will be a custom pot, so I cannot tell you what size to make it for your machine. But that there is one guy over there on YouTube has a Grizzly machine. His machine makes the same noise. And it likely is not the spindle bearings. It likely is that spline collet. So anybody has any more questions about this machine, if I left something out or you want to know something, thanks for watching. Thumbs up would be great. I'll give you the answer.